When you lost your famous belt, the greater part of your own power was gone from you. Against Ozma, you and your nomes would have no show at all." Roquat's eyes flashed angrily. "Then away with you to the slicing machine," he cried.
"Not yet," said the general, filling his pipe from the king's private tobacco pouch.
"What do you propose to do?" asked the monarch.
"I propose to obtain the power we need," answered Guph. "There are a good many evil creatures who have magic powers, sufficient to destroy and conquer the Land of Oz. We will get them on our side, band them all together, and then take Ozma and her people by surprise. It's all very simple and easy when you know how. Alone, we should be helpless to injure the ruler of Oz, but with the aid of the evil powers we can summon, we shall easily succeed." King Roquat was delighted with this idea, for he realized how clever it was.
"Surely, Guph, you are the greatest general I have ever had," he exclaimed, his eyes sparkling with joy. "You must go at once and make all arrangements with the evil powers to assist us, and meantime I'll begin to dig the tunnel."
"I thought you'd agree with me, Roquat," replied the new general. "I'll start this very afternoon to visit the chief of the Whimsies."
End of chapter 4. Chapter 5. How Dorothy Became a Princess. When the people of the Emerald City heard that Dorothy had returned to them, everyone was eager to see her, for the little girl was a general favorite in the Land of Oz. From time to time, some of the folk from the great outside world had found their way into this fairyland, but all except one had been the companions of Dorothy, and had turned out to be very agreeable people. The exception I speak of was the wonderful Wizard of Oz, a sleight-of-hand performer from Omaha, who went up in a balloon and was carried by a current of air to the Emerald City.